time now for everybody's favorite guessing game, What's My Line? Brought to you by Helene Curtis, makers of Starbet, Suave, and Enden Dandruff Treatment Shampoo. Now, let's all play What's My Line?
And now let's meet our award-winning What's My Line panel. First, the popular columnist whose voice of Broadway appears in papers from coast to coast, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
I'm very happy to be able to announce that we have playing a return engagement tonight, the most lovable member of the cast of the Broadway show Little Abner, Stubby Kay.
And now here's a young lady who comes to you direct from a weekend of cooking for the family, Miss Arlene Francis.
It's true, and I have the burns to prove it. And now our publisher panelist, Mr. Bennett, sir.
Now rounding out another year of leading contestants on this program and misleading the panel, our moderator, Mr. John Daly.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to What's My Line. Panel, we haven't come to the new year yet, but I like to get a running start on the new year and do something that's going to please you all mightily. Please put on your blindfold. Thank you.
Oh, well.
And, of course, we'd like to finish out this year. And this is with a full understanding that some of you will probably see this program after the new year has begun. We'd like to finish out in the practical terms of tonight, finish out the year by giving the panel a rough time of it, and we think we're going to. We've got some very interesting occupations and some nice people with them. We'll also have a famous mystery guest before the panel a little bit later in the show, and we'll meet our first challenger in just 1 minute.
I remember when the baby came to our house. Papa said, she looks so bare. Whatever happened to her hair? Mama said, it will be there. And Mama knew. As you can see, the hair grew, lovely as can be. Then came the time Mom said to Sis, to keep my hair lovely, I use this. For only Helene Curtis Suave can make hair gleam without that ugly, oily sheen. Dull, dry hair is never nice. No man ever glances twice unless hair has that healthy glow. That's why you need Suave, you know. So she used Suave. Her hair behaved and was so soft. And beaux flocked round her just to see Suave highlights twinkling prettily. So she'll use Suave for all her life to keep herself a pretty wife. Did you use Suave today? Helene Curtis Suave? Choose liquid or cream. Only Suave contains greaseless lanolin.
And now, with the blindfolds all in place, are they, panel?
Yes, sir.
Let's meet our first challenger. Will you come in and sign in, please? Scoring system?
I think so.
Fine. If you're familiar with our scoring system, let's let the folks at home and our friends here in the theater know exactly what your line is. Panel, as you undoubtedly have already guessed, there is an area of identification here which would reveal too much if you were not blindfolded. It could be in costuming or appearance or signature on the board, etc., etc., etc. However, to be helpful, we will tell you that our challenger is salaried, and we'll begin the general questioning with Bennett, sir.
Well, I heard you say, I think so, in a masculine voice, did I not?
Yes.
Are we masked because we might have seen your picture in the paper?
Yes.
That's possible, yes, Bennett.
Are you dressed in some special paraphernalia that is unlike what you would wear on the street in ordinary circumstances?
No.
That's one down and nine to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Then at this moment, your costume is the same as you would wear walking down Lexington Avenue. Is that right?
Yes.
Would any of us on this panel recognize your face, do you think?
This, if I may intrude and answer the question, would depend a good deal on certain specific areas of interest that you each might have, and I don't think that we are competent to say specifically that any one of you would recognize individually the face.
Oh, John, you're competent to say anything you want to say. Would you say that to those who have a specific area of interest, which perhaps is a secret between you and our moderator, there would be people who would recognize your face as well as your name?
Yes.
Would you say that you are in a profession where possibly your name is more famous than your face?
It's a very difficult question to answer, Dorothy, because here again, we have to have some reference to a specific applied area of interest.
Are you in some business or profession other than the entertainment world?
No.
That's two down and eight to go, Mr. K.
Are you in the entertainment world?
Yes.
Very good, Mr. K.
Well, I got off Lexington Avenue. You perform before the public, do you?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Do you perform, do you perform alone? Come.
No.
Three down and seven to go, Miss Francis.
Do you operate with a team?
Yes.
Are you part of the sports world?
Yes.
Have you ever appeared at Madison Square Garden, or would you be liable to?
Yes.
Do you appear on ice ever?
No.
Four Let me right up the alley.
Mr. Surf.
You must have seen the Steve Allen show.
Yeah.
You do not appear on ice.
That's correct.
Am I correct that there are more than one of you here?
Yes.
Is there a team here?
Yes.
Didn't sound like it.
Madison Square Garden. Well, if it isn't hockey, is it basketball?
Yes.
Is it my turn?
Now, wait a minute. Is basketball?
I was going to say I passed, Bennett.
Is it a professional basketball team?
Yes.
Did you play tonight?
Yes.
Are you famous for all kinds of fancy dribbling and trick shots?
Yes.
You the Globetrotters?
Right.
Yes.
If I may, their spokesman, Clarence Wilson, but I'd like you individually to take a bow, if you will, as I say your name, so you can all meet the Harlem Globetrotters, who are our guests. Meadowlark Lemon, Charlie Hoxie, Roman Terman, Andy Johnson, Woodrow Salisbury, Carl Green, Leon Hillard, Willie Gardner, Pop Gates, who is the coach, Parnell Woods, who is the manager, and Paul Hardy, who is also manager. Paul here?
No, he's not here.
Oh, Paul's not here. Paul didn't come. All right, dock him. That's
John,
all we can do.
John, would one of these wonderful fellows dribble a ball around a little and show us?
No, we haven't got a ball. I don't think.
Sure he has. I can see it in his hand.
Oh, dribble one. That was Leon Hillard doing
that.
I'd
like to see him now make a basket.
I must say, this makes Bennett and I very homesick. When we used to play for our respective secondary schools, we didn't look like that a bit, did we, Bennett? No, I must say seriously for a moment, the Harlem Globetrotters, of course, have won, and very justly, great fame in the field of basketball as a sport, but they're also known as the goodwill ambassadors of sports. They've, in their way, as they played the sport and demonstrated their skills, represented our country far and wide throughout the Orient and Asia. In fact, I think when this next year is over, you'll have been just about everywhere, won't you?
Yeah.
And just in case you were wondering about what happened tonight, they won 75-53. What else? Thanks very much to all of you for being our guests. Get too far with that panel, but let's see if we can't fix you with another challenger. Would you come in and sign in, please?
That's potentially dangerous. Catherine? Anne? Is that Mortz?
Mort.
Is it Miss or Mrs. Mortz?
Miss.
Miss Mortz. And where are you from?
Spokane, Washington.
Spokane, Washington. Well, it's nice to have you with us. Here is our panel. And now if you'll come over here and sit down next to me. I wonder if, coming all the way from Spokane, you're familiar with our scoring system.
Yes, I am.
All right, fine. Then let's let everybody at home and here know exactly what your line is. Miss Mortz is salaried, and let's begin the general questioning with Arlene Francis.
Do you work for a profit-making organization, Miss Mortz?
No.
One down and nine to go, Mr. Surf.
Miss Mortz, I guess I can assume that you do not make Mortz balls.
No.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm glad we're finishing out a year and not starting one with that.
That was for you, John. Miss Mortz, do you work in some governmental job?
Yes.
Would it be the federal government?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Do you work at a desk job, Miss Ford?
Yes.
Yes, in a manner of speaking.
You are. Yes. Would you say that you were indoors more than you were outdoors in pursuit of your work?
Yes.
Do you do it in the state of Washington?
Yes.
Is it a local rather than a state job?
We'll huddle on that one.
Local rather than state.
All right.
Keep it moving, John.
It's a local job for John's behavior.
Now, I would say, Dorothy, that we would agree it has a local connotation.
I see. In other words, you work for some branch of some government other than the state of Washington, right?
Yes.
Do you do your work in or near Spokane?
Yes.
Are people better off because of what you do?
Sometimes.
Mm-hmm. Could you also cause some distress or consternation in some areas by what you do?
Sometimes.
Do you have any power to arrest people or take them into custody?
Another consultation.
Yes.
Wouldn't you think she'd know if she hadn't?
She hasn't arrested anybody lately.
Yeah, I think we would have to say that there is a power there that certainly could be applied to the end that somebody might be taken into custody or be arrested. Mm-hmm.
Well, now, this is a terribly shady answer that you've given, John. If she turns out to be a lady policeman, may I rule out the possibility of your being a policewoman?
Yes.
Thank you.
See, we're not shady. We're just big, 100% open-faced, 100% American.
All right. Do you have any judiciary powers?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Are you a magistrate or judge of some kind?
Yeah.
No?
Oh, my. Yes, indeed.
I apologize for calling you shady, John.
Miss the judge, you know, you don't do that. You better stay out of Spokane for a while, don't you think?
Yes.
Now, actually, Miss Mortz is a judge, has been since she was 24 years old, right?
Yes. And now she's 25?
Well, I didn't ever pry into things like that. All I know is that Miss Mortz was elected as a judge for 2 years by the constituency of her county, and she's reputedly the youngest judge in the county. Is that right? In the country,
America.
I mean. Not the county.
Miss Mortz, what do you judge? Beauty contest?
Let me shut Bennett up. She handles all the traffic cases, can give you 6 months in jail or take a judgment against you in the amount of $200. You want to play?
No.
You don't want to play. All right. Well, I must say that you've been such a lovely guest. We'll flip all those anyway and wish you a happy new year and thanks for being our guest. Nice to have you with us, Judge. Mystery guest in just a moment, but first here is a word from Helene Curtis.
Caught you this time with the same old problem. Don't you know there's a new proven way to end your dandruff problems once and for all?
This is new Helene Curtis Andon Dandruff Treatment Shampoo. The first proven medical treatment in shampoo form available without prescription.
Okay, now, just shampoo with Andon. Feels good, doesn't it? Now, comb your hair. Look at your comb. And this'll make you even happier. Endon is guaranteed to end itching, flaking, and scaling due to dandruff. And to prevent their return. Sure, your wife should use it instead of an ordinary shampoo. And doctors approve Endon for children, too. What do you say now?
I say if you've got dandruff problems, Endon is sure the easiest way to stop them. For good.
That's Endon. Proved 99% effective. No prescription needed. Guaranteed by Helene Curtis, foremost name in hair care. Endon Dandruff Treatment Shampoo.
Millions of people have discovered how wonderful it is not to be bothered by dandruff. They found out how Endon ends dandruff flaking and scalp irritation, stops bacteria growth, prevents reinfection as you shampoo your hair. And now a suggestion. Once Endon has ended your dandruff problems, continue using Endon to prevent them from returning. You'll like refreshing Endon as your regular shampoo. Use Helene Curtis Endon Dandruff Treatment Shampoo. Big jar, only $1.50.
Presents another profile of an African-American great. The Modern Jazz Quartet. Emerging from Dizzy Gillespie's band, their chic take on jazz broke ground, moving them out of the clubs into the concert hall. They earned many honors, including the first NAACP Award for Cultural Contributions in Music and honorary doctorates from Berklee College. In 73, they played live on What's My Line. This episode is coming up next on Buzzer.
Now we come to the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery celebrity, for which I've had to ask my friends on the panel to blindfold themselves once again. Are the blindfolds all in place, panel?
Yes. Yes.
Yep.
Good. Will you come in, mystery challenger, and sign in, please? Panel, as you know, in the case of our mystery challenger, we go to a different form of questioning. You ask one question at a time in turn, moving clockwise. And we'll begin it with Stubby K.
Hi.
Hi.
Oh! Are you in the entertainment world?
Yes.
Miss Francis?
Have you appeared in pictures?
Yes.
Mr. Surf?
Tough guy. Have you appeared on the in legitimate theater?
Yes.
Are you a leading man, hero type?
No.
One down and nine to go, Mr. K.
Are you a comedian?
50-50.
50-50.
Miss Francis?
Are you around 50?
I am here.
Yes.
Mr. Surf?
I'm going to withdraw from this. I knew this voice the minute he talked. And I don't think it's fair to go on. Because his boy went to school with my boy, I'll swear to that. Am I right on that?
Did Bennett's boy go to school with your boy?
He's psychic.
Leave it be. All right, Bennett. Bennett withdraws. Miss Kilgallen.
That didn't help me a bit. Are you also a personality on television?
Yes.
Mr. Kay, are you appearing anywhere in New York now?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Miss Francis.
Well, I'm with Bennett. My boy didn't appear with your boy in school, but I once did on the stage. Is that much true?
Yes.
All right, that answers the question. Miss Kilgallen.
Stuffy. Dear boy.
Dorothy, it's you and I on this island.
My kids went to the wrong school.
Have you... what? I'm not married. What can be
Dorothy,
my problem?
Stubby, Dorothy's got a question.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Well, I wasn't really using it up, so it was perfectly all right if Stubby wanted to take
please,
it, but I'll
ahead.
Ask something. When you played on the stage with Arlene, was that within the last 5 years?
No.
Three down and seven to go, Mr. K. Huh?
Do you appear in nightclubs?
No.
Four down and six to go. Miss
Would you
Francis,
like to
do you
appear
wish
in...
to pass?
No, I wish to say who it is because he's so heavenly.
All right, who is it?
I wish to say it's Bert Lahr.
That's right.
Bert could have at least said that our children have danced together, my daughter and his handsome son, even if they didn't go to the same schools. That would have been a clue.
Dorothy, by the way, Johnny is out there tonight.
Marvelous. Hi, Johnny.
Oh, I wish we could see him. Actually, you have three youngsters, haven't you?
No, two.
Two?
But a very large youngster.
Very
he's in
large.
Tucson, Arizona.
You mean he had to stay out there because he's so big?
Oh, no, no. He's living there.
No, living there.
They get very big.
My eldest is 6 feet, 2 1/2, and, you know, he can lick... well, no, he can't really, but...
Is that your eldest?
Yeah.
Well, 6 feet, 2 1/2. My big boy's about that size, too.
John.
He grew fast. He's very young. What?
Could I ask Bert one question?
Yes.
I don't want to embarrass you, Bert, but you appeared in a play last year called Waiting for Godot.
Yes.
Did you know what it was all about?
Did you?
No, sir.
Then we're even.
Now, I have my analysis of the thing. It pleased me, and that's all that mattered, and it pleased a lot of people.
Oh, you were wonderful, and I didn't know what it was all about.
Well, that was life. It's waiting for...
And nobody knows what that's about, do they, Bert?
I can see where we can get into the labyrinthine way if we stay in this path.
Or abstract.
Or all abstract. Well, Bennett is an abstract of something or the other. I mean, Bennett is sometimes abstract. Bert, I want to thank you very much for giving us some of your time with the holiday season on. It's good of you to come to visit us, and you honor us by so doing. For all, I would say, Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to
many,
you.
Many, many of them. Can you say good luck to the having an exceedingly good night. Perhaps we can trip you up before things are concluded. Let's have another challenger. Will you come in and sign in, please? Walter? Grancher or Grancher, is that? Grancher. Grancher, where are you from?
New York City.
New York City. Mm-hmm. I offer the panel, and now I offer you a chair. Will you come in here and sit down? You know how we score?
Yes, I do.
All right, Mr. Grancher, let's let everybody around and about except the panel know exactly what your line is. All right. Panel, Mr. Grancher is salaried, and we'll begin the general questioning with Dorothy Kilgallen.
Do you work for a profit-making organization, Mr. Grancher?
No.
One
no.
down
no.
and nine to go, Mr. K.
Do you work for the government?
Yes, I do.
You do? Would it be the federal government?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Gee, that's nice.
No conference was called for. Please, Mr. K., will you proceed?
Well, we
with
were
the
still
question?
Alone on the island. I'm sorry. Is there a product involved in what you do?
Yes.
There is a product. Is it a product that's found in the home?
No.
No. 2 down and 8 to go, Miss Francis.
Is the product with which you are involved in... could it ever be used in wartime?
Yes.
Is it a dangerous product?
It would be considered so by some, yes.
Does it move in any way under its own steam?
Yes.
Would it be used ever for transportation?
Yes.
If not directly so, we would have to agree that people or objects could be transported.
That's right.
Hmm. What?
Why?
is it ever in the sky rather than on land or on the water?
No.
That's 3 down and 7 to go, Mr. Sir.
It's never in the air.
No.
Is it on the land?
No.
No. That's 4 down and 6 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Is it in the water?
Yes.
Does it ever go below the surface of the water?
On bad days.
It could.
Deliberately?
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, is it part of the Navy or the Marine Corps operation?
Yes.
Is it? All right, I'll say it. Is it in the submarine class?
Could be.
Oh, it could be. But you would deal with something other than submarines, too?
Yes.
Do you deal with things that don't go underwater, that just stay on the water?
Yes.
Oh. Do you ever wear a uniform? It's different from what you're wearing
now? That's 5 down and 5 to go.
I pass.
Miss Preston.
Would usually only one person handle this, whatever it is?
No.
That makes it 6 down and 4 to go, Mr. Sir.
Have you got something to do with the procurement department of the Navy?
No.
7 down and 3 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
May we get back to ships?
Sure,
again?
Go ahead.
You deal directly with some type of operation that is...
Navigable.
Navigable. Thank you, Arnie.
Yes.
Do you have anything to do with designing or ordering these ships?
No.
No. And I'm going to flip all the cards because our time is up and I don't think you'd ever get this. What?
I just wanted to ask, do you deal with anything that has to do with atomic-powered...
Stubby? Atomic-powered...
No.
Atomic?
No.
No.
That's right. Yeah. Mr. Grancher sells used warships for the United States Navy.
Oh.
I want to explain very quickly that he is a civil service employee, and he invites bids on obsolete ships, only obsolete ships, and there's a small little old aircraft carrier lying around if anybody wants to bid on it. And thank you very much, sir, for being our guest. We fooled him, and glad to do it. Happy New Year. Now, before our panel says goodnight, here is a word from next week's sponsor.
Tonight is Univac, the giant electronic brain made only by Remington Rand. It's the first electronic computing system to be proven by widespread use. Because of its exclusive self-checking features, Univac cannot make an error. Be sure to tune in next week when we'll show you Univac in one of its most exciting and useful applications to the field of business. At work for the Sylvania Electric Products Company.
Fully realizing that some of you may get this after the new year has started, a very simple message, Happy New Year to you all. And until next week, this is John Daly saying good night, Miss Dorothy.
Good night, John. Happy New Year to you. And Stubby, we'll be watching you on the Dinosaur Show January 13th. Good night.
Thank you. Good night, and good night to you, Arlene.
Good night, Stubby. Good luck. Good night, dear Bennett.
Good to have you back, Stubby. Thank Happy you. 1957. Night, John.
And if I may, to the panel, Happy New Year to all of you. Good night, ladies and gentlemen, and thanks for being with us on What's My Line.
This has been a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production in association with the CBS Television Network.